So Microsoft is expected to acquire Activision for a ton of money, and if the deal goes through, Microsoft will become the adoptive parents to loads of massive franchises. But that also means Microsoft is acquiring Activision's 43-year legacy, and with it, some legendary and not so legendary IPs they've picked up along the way. In a lot of ways, Microsoft buying Activision is like moving into a house and finding all the weird shit the old tenants left behind in the attic. And it appears that Xbox Daddy X Phil Spencer is ready to find what's between the sofa cushions. Really, Phil Spencer told the Washington Post that he's eager to revive some of Activision's old games. And let's all hope that it's not Leisure Suit Larry. So, let's pull some of those boxes out from Activision's musty old basement and take a look at the abandoned franchises Microsoft now potentially owns. First, we're gonna blow the dust off Sierra Entertainment. Sierra were giants in this industry. Formed the same year as Activision back in 1979, founders Ken and Roberta Williams were pioneers in the interactive medium, responsible for the first graphic adventure game, Mystery House. What followed was a series of games that influenced the entire medium. Games like King's Quest, Space Quest, Police Quest, Quest for Glory, Leisure Suit Larry, Gabriel Knight, and most importantly, the gold mine that Microsoft now sits upon, Phantasmagoria. Phantasmagoria was Roberta Williams' magnum opus. For years, Roberta had wanted to make a horror game, but held off until the technology was there to tell the story how she had always envisioned it. It wasn't until CD-ROMs became faster and could handle real actors that she decided to go all in on her first horror escapade. And horror, it certainly was. Phantasmagoria is about a woman who moves into a remote mansion with her husband, but is soon tormented by supernatural forces that rip her world and marriage apart. It's dark, extremely graphic, and takes many liberties to convey its horror. A radical contrast to Roberta's previous, rather light-hearted adventures. When it was released in 1995, it garnered a lot of controversy for its depiction of adult themes and violence. Nor did Sierra Entertainment shy away from owning it. Phantasmagoria's true legacy is in taking a daring step in using the medium, as well as cutting-edge technology at the time, to tell a powerful and horrifying story seldom seen in games. All that said, Microsoft has a potential revival for a horror franchise here. Or, you know, they could just put it on Game Pass or something, at least. Its sequel, however, that's a box that might want to stay in the Activision attic. Tucked under the stairs is Raven Software's family photo album. Raven, most commonly known today as being a support studio for Call of Duty, came from a lineage of classic first-person shooters, like Heretic, or the hyper-violent Soldiers of Fortune, and the badass dark fantasy RPG Hexen. While Microsoft now owns the mighty fantasy Elder Scrolls series, Hexen falls more into the Doom category of action, and the potential to revive it with that DNA could be sweet to see. It's also just kinda cool to see that Raven and id Software are now roomies again. But then, there's Singularity, Raven's last big outing before shifting over to being a Call of Duty support studio. Singularity attempted to be a lot of things, with inspirations and mechanics ranging from Fear, BioShock, and Half-Life 2. It mixed special abilities with first-person shooting with a sprinkle of horror. Its use of combining special powers into the shooter genre was also an idea Raven Software explored in their rather bemused take on Wolfenstein in 2009, which also gave BJ Blazkowicz supernatural abilities. And black hair. But unlike Wolfenstein, the mashing of concepts shined in Singularity. It's something of a lost gem for 2010 shooters, one that Xbox may want to examine for its potential in the future. Now, I know Radical Entertainment for Jackie Chan's Stunt Master.
Radical Entertainment.
But I'm willing to bet most of you probably know them for Prototype. Prototype was an accumulation of Radical's best efforts, like The Incredible Hulk Ultimate Destruction, put into an original IP, setting the player loose in an open-world sandbox using slick traversal and over-the-top superpowers. Radical Entertainment was made a support team for Destiny, but now that Sony is set to acquire Bungie, it's unclear what Radical is working on next under the Activision roof. Look, even if Microsoft doesn't give them the chance to make the once-canceled Prototype 3, they should try to work out a sweet deal with Marvel to get another Hulk Ultimate Destruction underway. As for Jackie Chan's Dunmaster, leave it alone. It's a gem, and it's perfect exactly how it is. I'm sure Neversoft has its own room in the Activision abode. One that has Tony Hawk and Guitar Hero memorabilia everywhere, and a little statue to commemorate Gunn. But if Phil decided to look under the carpet, I'm sure he'd find Apocalypse, the action shooter starring Bruce Willis. Now, if I'm being completely honest, I don't see a future in which this exists. But I deemed it appropriate to live here in this video, as I did not know about its existence since beginning my research. Now, I feel somehow compelled to play it only to hear Bruce Willis scream, "Suck on this!
Suck on this!"
while System of the Down concerts play on giant screens amidst exploding buildings. It's a thing. And of course, there's the legacy Activision has with its very own IPs that helped kick this entire industry off, like Pitfall. Sure, there's Uncharted and Tomb Raider, but now Microsoft has its own adventurous IP to swing and traverse the eclectic jungles of the world. I mean, well, but then again, Machine Games is working on an Indiana Jones game, which Microsoft now also owns. Whatever. Anyways, let's not forget about the True Crime series. Yes, Sleeping Dogs was very much the spiritual successor to True Crime, which was once True Crime Hong Kong, a canceled sequel until the publishing rights were picked up by Square Enix. Still, Activision owned the True Crime trademark until abandoning it in 2014. All in all, it's easy to see Activision for what it is now, with Call of Duty and everything Blizzard. But it's astonishing how deeply rooted the company's legacy goes, owning IPs responsible for shaping the entire medium, stuff like the seminal text adventure Zork. Of course, the massive deal for Microsoft to acquire Activision Blizzard isn't set to close until 2023, and even then, the deal's expected to undergo investigation by the US's Federal Trade Commission to ensure the deal will not harm competition and consumers. In the meantime, Phil Spencer's vocalization of exploring previous IPs sparks plenty of speculation on what Microsoft could resurrect, like Phantasmagoria. But it'll probably likely be Leisure Suit Larry. Yeah. Anyways, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed it, make sure to do the thumbs up thing. And if you want more content like this, you should also consider subscribing if you're not already. Okay, till next time, see you later.